Speaking of the outside angle, Commissioner Johansson.
Yes, thank you. Thank you very much. And today the Commission has adopted a new recommended coordinated approach on all forms of travel to and from third countries to the European Union. And this is based on the changes in the epidemiological situation over the last weeks and months. All non-essential travel, especially to and from high-risk areas, should be strongly discouraged until the epidemiological situation has considerably improved. Most notably, the proposal today aims at addressing the nature of the virus present in any third country, in particular, where the variants of concern of the virus have been detected. Mutations are hard by definition to track, to assess, and to contain. In June, we, the Commission, proposed a list of countries to the EU that could have non-essential travel. Since then, this list has unfortunately gotten shorter and shorter and shorter. Our priority has to be to minimize transmission and ultimately infection rates. That's why we today are proposing new measures which include testing for all arrivals to the European Union, including essential travelers. For any travel to the European Union, there should be a PCR test in 72 hours before departure. Member states are also strongly encouraged to set up additional measures for countries where variants of a concern of the virus have been detected, such as self-isolation, quarantine, and contact tracing for a period up to 14 days. EU citizens and residents should be given the possibility to test upon arrival to make sure that they're not being stuck in the third country and not being able to come back as quick as possible. A passenger locator form should be an obligation, and we should move as soon as possible to European passenger locator form. Our colleagues, Commissioner Dina Valian, and also together with Stella Kyriakides, are working on this right now. It's important that we keep essential travel possible, even though they have to make this test in advance. Travel back to European Union by EU or long-term residents and their family members remains essential. Love remains essential. And travel for workers across borders and transport workers, for example, for pilots. So this is, they need to be able to travel quite easily, even with these new measures. The member states, as Didier already mentioned, will discuss this in the IPCR already this afternoon. As I have said since March, when external restrictions on non-essential travel were first introduced, and in June, when we measured the response during the summer period, the effectiveness of these proposals are based on member states' ability to work quickly and as much as possible in fully coordinated manner, in a consistent manner. A European approach at our common European external borders, clearly communicated to citizens in advance. And of course, the Commission stands ready to assist in all of the above. Thank you.